It's 1862. Our nation is quaking from its shakening. Civil War comes forth just after the Second Great Awakening. Breaking the shell of dead religion, Holy Ghost brought conviction, stoking fires of abolition and birthing societies of manumission. Let the slave go free, became the refrain of the white preacher, like William Wilberforce, Elijah Lovejoy, and Lyman Beecher. You know, the father of Harriet Beecher Stowe. She wrote Uncle Tom's Cabin, a best-selling novel that prophesied slavery must go. Fictional, it was based upon the true life of a man I cannot fail to mention, a fugitive slave from Maryland, Reverend Apostle Josiah Henson. Illiterate, he opened up the book and said, "Father, teach me. Unlock the scroll, fill my soul so I can preach thee." He made it to Canada. Together with others, bought 300 acres of land, built a church, built a school, and houses with his own hands, built furniture, shipped it around the world, and then discipled an army and sonship. They were not mere men. Oh, the revelation they carried warrants, I say it again. We're so much more than slaves. We're not mere men. Brave identity. You see, it produces a brave faith. That's why today I start by unpacking the mystery of my ancestral slaves' faith. And not just because it's February, you know, the month of Black history, but because we've come here to plumb the depths of the great mystery. Jesus himself, you know, the sovereign who reigns, the one who sustained Harriet Tubman as she conducted the freedom train. Led by visions and dreams, she traversed through swamps and streams. Time and again, going back, tearing slavery at its seams, all for love. The captives followed her in lines, valentines, no roses. They called her Moses, no platform, no poses. Time and again, God brings us into seasons that expose us in whom or what we trust. Perhaps like Rosa, the moment she refused to move from the front of the bus. When it's time to behave or be brave, will we have fear of man, or will we trust in the truth that God can do it? See, I got a great, great, great cloud of witnesses as my witness. They got a great, great, great stake in the now. They're heavily invested in my business. You see, we have come over a way that with tears has been watered. We have come treading our path through the blood of the slaughtered sons and daughters. Brave faith was the recipe. Through tears and fears, my mothers fought for my destiny. Church, as the first Black pastor among mostly white faces, she saw that I would need a brave identity just to navigate these spaces. Now I have a confidence that almost cannot be measured. I'm no longer a slave as I hear my father say my name. Treasured.